Are you constantly thinking about how to get strong bones? Then this video is for you. Hey, this is Neha and you're watching NCTV. Just a few days back, I uploaded a video in which I said I gave up dairy, and I actually told you about the side effects that dairy had on our body. And I was flooded with one question, and that was, Neha, where do we get our calcium from to build strong bones? So people, I decided to make this video to make sure you get your calcium myths sorted and your bones remain strong for the entire lifetime. So the point is that dairy and dairy products are really acidic for the body and they are not digested in the system. Now the whole point of getting calcium to your bones is by letting the calcium being absorbed into your system. Now when your milk and milk products are not even digested in your system because we generally lack the enzyme lactase to digest milk and milk products, how will you get your calcium which is there in the milk? So there's no digestion and definitely no absorption of calcium happening. The dairy industry has done a fantastic job in promoting milk as the sole food rich in calcium for strong bones. But the fact is that every food that you eat has calcium in it, be it your vegetables, fruits, nuts, grains. All these foods have good amount of calcium which are readily absorbed. Also, calcium is just not the mineral that is needed for strong bones. To help calcium to get into your bones and build into strong bone mass, you need magnesium, potassium, phosphorus, silica, vitamin C, protein, and a lot of other nutrients to make sure that your bones form strong and nice. But people still keep fretting about calcium and they want to eat calcium-rich foods to make sure that they don't lose their bones. So today I'm going to tell you my top 5 foods which if you consume in your daily diet, you don't need to worry about your calcium intake. So the first on my list are the greens. Now your green leafy vegetables like parsley, mint, coriander, kale are super rich in calcium. I wouldn't consider spinach as a part of this because calcium in spinach is bound with oxalate, which doesn't get very well absorbed in the body. But all your other greens are a great source of calcium. Not only calcium, but they also have magnesium, potassium, which I said are so important for bone formation. One glass of green smoothie a day can easily replace your one glass of milk and you don't need to worry about your calcium intake then. The second food on my list are sesame seeds, white sesame seeds, and these are such cute tiny little seeds which are so abundant in calcium. All you need to do is roast them, grind them coarsely if you want to make sure you get the best of the nutrients that are inside the seed because the outer covering is really hard. So it might not get digested in your body, but when you coarsely grind it, you make sure you absorb all the calcium what is there inside and just make a paste, add it to your salads, to your soup, to your dals, or just coarsely grind the powder and top your salads or porridge with this tiny cute seed. Next on my list is ragi or nachni. Now this is a very common millet and we Indians are blessed with so many millets that we don't even know of, and ragi is actually a poor man's source of calcium because this is so cheap, it's not expensive, it's so readily available in India, and they are so rich in calcium. So you can actually just have a porridge of this, or the roti of nachni is really healthy. Now I've come up with my own nachni khakras with sesame seeds, so they are again great source of calcium. You can add ragi as a part of your daily diet in your lunch or dinner and you're sorted with your calcium. The fourth ones are dried figs, and these are my personal favorite. I love them. So rich in iron, so rich in energy, and so rich in calcium. Not only calcium, but even magnesium and potassium. So they form perfect food and perfect ingredient for strong bones. So 2 or 3 a day, you're great to go. They're great snacks. You can carry them in your bag and they up your energy and they up your bone mass. The fifth on my list is amaranth seeds. Now these are really ancient millets again in India, and they can be had as khichdi, porridge, upma. You can roast them and powder them and add it to your laddus or whatever form you want to. You can even puff them and eat it as popcorn or add it to your porridge. They are again very rich in calcium and magnesium and phosphorus. So these were my top 5 foods which I feel if you consume in your day-to-day life, you really don't need to worry about your calcium. But again, like I said, it's not just the amount of calcium that you eat, but also the amount of bone loss or calcium loss that you prevent. So how do you do that? First, reduce your salt and sugar intake, because these are really acidic foods and they leach calcium out of your body. Again, caffeine in the form of tea or coffee, they make sure that you lose your bones, and osteoporosis is the near future for you. Third, animal proteins are excessively acidic for the body and they again leach calcium from your bones when eaten in very high amounts. And you need to get yourself moving. If you want to preserve your calcium in your bones, get moving, because when you move, your body builds stronger and tougher bones. And lastly, don't forget my vitamin D, which I say in all my videos. Get enough of the sunshine and then you don't need to fret about your bones. No osteoporosis, no arthritis. So I hope now all your myths regarding bone, calcium, bone loss is now clear. But if you still have any doubts, myths or suggestions, you can put it down in the comments below. Don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. Share it with all your friends and family who you think this video would help. And of course, don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you want the videos directly in your inbox. And as I always say, don't forget to be healthy, beautiful, and stay strong.